Hello students of class 9th. Now I am going to start the Merchant of Venice, Act 3, Scene 1. Your MO portion is Act 1, Act 2 and Act 3, Scene 1. So, by this way, this is the last scene of the Merchant of Venice, which is in a portion. Now, Act 3, Scene 1, a Venice, a street, enters Celeno and Salerno. In this scene, Celeno and Salerno are present. The scene is taking place in Venice, a street. Salerno says, "Now what news on the Rialto? What news from the Venetian Stock Exchange? What is the news from Venetian Stock Exchange?" Salerno says, "Why? Yet it lives there unchecked that Antonio hath a ship of rich leading wrecked on the narrow seas. The good winds, I think, they call a place a very dangerous flat and fatal where the carcasses of many a tall ship lie buried. As they say, if my gossip report be an honest woman of her word." Salerno says here, there is an apparently confirmed news. This is a confirmed news that the news says that one of Antonio's ship with expensive cargo is destroyed in the narrow sea channel. This is apparently confirmed report, apparently confirmed news. I think that they call the place Goodwin. Goodwin is the place. Goodwin Sands is the place where many good ships are believed to have been destroyed and their parts lie buried. This is a dangerous shallow place. Goodwin Sands, a dangerous shallow place where many good ships are believed to have been destroyed and their parts lie buried, if a talkative woman's rumor is to be believed. Salerno says, "I would she were as lying a gossip in that ever nabbed ginger or made her neighbors believe she wept for the death of a third husband. But it is true without any ships of prolixity or crossing the plain highway of talk that the Goodwin, the good Antonio, the honest Antonio, oh that I had a little good enough to keep his name company. I only hope," Salerno says, is the speech of Salerno, "I hope that Madam Rumor, who spreads the rumor, is as big as a liar as an old woman who chewed ginger and made her neighbors believe that she wept when her third husband died." Without speaking much or beating about the bush, I don't want to say unnecessarily thing, only I come to the point. I have fear, I am afraid that the noble Antonio, I wish I could find an adjective suitable enough to be added to his name. Salerno appreciates Antonio and says that if I could find an adjective suitable enough to be added to appreciate his name. Salerno says, "Come on, tell the full stop. Come on, put an end to your story." Salerno says, "Ha, what sayest thou? Why, the end is hath lost a ship." "What did you say?" "The sum and substance is that Antonio has lost a ship." Salerno says, "Let me say amen betimes, let the devil cross my prayer, for here he comes in the likeness of a Jew." Salerno says here, "Let me say quickly amen to that wish immediately before the devil can ruin it, destroy it, for here comes the devil in the form of a Jew." Here, Shylock's entry is here in the scene. He says, "Say amen to that wish immediately." The wish, what is the wish? That I hope it may be the end of his losses. If one ship has lost, no problem. But I hope it may be the end of his losses. he says that this wish immediately be fulfilled. Let me say quickly amen to this wish immediately before the devil can destroy it, devil can ruin it. Here comes the devil in the form of a Jew. Now enter Shylock here. Shylock, how now, Shylock? What news among the merchants? Well, Shylock, what is the news today among the merchants? He asked the news. If there is any important news, Shylock says, you knew none so well as you of my daughter's flight. Shylock says, you better than anyone else know well that my daughter has eloped. My daughter's flight has eloped. Cyrano says, that's certain. I, for my part, knew the tailor that made the wings she flew with all. Cyrano says here, that is quite correct. This is all right. This is quite correct. I know the tailor who made the cloth in which she eloped. Cyrano says, and Shylock, for his own part, knew the bird was fledged, and then it is the complexion of them all to leave the dam. Cyrano says, Shylock, for his part, knew that the young bird was ready to fly. She has become young. The bird was ready to fly, as it is the nature of all young birds to leave the mother. This is the nature. As it is the nature of all young birds to leave the mother, so his daughter also eloped with Lorenzo. Shylock says she is damned for it. Well, she will be damned for doing so. Cyrano says, that is certain, if the devil may be her judge. Cyrano says, that is sure. Surely she will be damned, because she is judged by the devil. That is sure, even if she is judged by the devil. He says, Shylock, a devil. Shylock says, my own flesh and blood to rebel. Oh, my own flesh and blood has rebelled against me. Now he is in sorrowful mood and says, my own flesh. He says about his daughter and says, my own flesh and blood has rebelled against me. Cyrano says, there is more difference between thy flesh and hers than between jet and ivory, more between your bloods than there is between red wine and Rhenish. But tell us, do you hear where Antonio have had any loss at sea or no? Cyrano says that there is more difference between you and her. Her means your daughter, than there is between two colors, black and white. There is much difference between black and white. So, you and your daughter have so much difference. There is more difference between your blood and hers than there is between ordinary red wine and the expensive white German wine. But tell me, have you heard whether Antonio has lost a ship at sea or not? Shylock says, there I have another bad match, a bankrupt, a prodigal who dares scarce show his head on the Rialto, a beggar that was used to come to smug upon the mart. Let him look to his bond. He was wont to call me usurer. Let him look to his bond. He was wont to lend money for Christian courtesy. Let him look to his bond. Shylock is in happy mood now. He says, there I have another bad bargain with a bankrupt, a spendthrift, a lavish person who can hardly show his face on the exchange. He is a beggar now, who used to come smiling, so self-satisfied, to the market. Let him take care of his bond. He used to call me a money lender. Let him take care of his bond. He must care of his bond. He used to lend money free of interest as an act of Christian charity, let him take care to redeem his bond in time. Sarino says, why, I am sure, if he forfeit, thou will not take his flesh, what they are good for? Sarino asks to Shylock, that, well, I am sure that if he fails to pay in time, he will not insist on taking his flesh. Of what good is that to you? What will you do with his flesh? It is of no use for you. Now Shylock says in anger to bait fish with all. If it will feed nothing else, it will feed my revenge. He had disgraced me and hindered me 500,000, laughed at my losses, mocked at my gains, scorned my nation, thwarted my bargains, cooled my friends, hated my enemies. What is his reason? I am a Jew. Hath not a Jew eyes? Hath not a Jew hands? Organs, dimensions, senses, affection, possessions? Fed with the same food, hurt with the same weapons, subject to the same diseases, healed by the same means, warmed and cooled by the same winter and summer, as a Christian is. If you prick us, do we not bleed? If you tickle us, do we not laugh? If you poison us, do we not die? And if you wrong us, shall we not revenge? If we are like you in the rest, we will resemble you in that. If a Jew wrong a Christian, what is his humility? Revenge. If a Christian wrong a Jew, what should his sufferance by Christian's example? Why revenge? The villainy you teach me, I will execute, and it shall go hard, but I will better the instruction. He says, to use, I will use his flesh as a bait to catch a fish. If it will feed nothing else, it will satisfy my thirst of revenge. He has humiliated me, he has insulted me, and made me lose 500,000 ducats. I am in loss of 500,000 ducats. He has made fun of my losses and mocked at my gains, despised my race, hated my race, interfered in my business deals, diminished my friends' affections, and incited my enemies. Why does he do such things? Why? Why does he do such things? It is only because I am a Jew. Has not a Jew eyes like other men? He asked the question. Has he not hands, physical organs, bodily form, the same senses, affection and passions? Is he not fed with the same food as the other men? Hurt by the same weapons, subject to the same diseases, healed by the same medicines, warmed by summer and cooled by winter, just as Christian is? If you prick us, do we not bleed? If you tickle us, do we not laugh? If you poison us, do we not die? If you wrong us, do we not take revenge? If we are like you in all the other things, we shall also be like you in those things. If a Jew does injustice to a Christian, does the Christian show humility? No, he will take revenge. Surely, he will take revenge. If a Christian wrongs a Jew, what should the Jew's reaction be according to the Christian's example? Why, it should be revenge. So, the wicked behavior that you teach me, I shall carry out, and it will be strange. If I do not improve upon the lesson you have taught me, I will do. Now enter a servant. Servant says here, gentlemen, my master Antonio is at your house and desires to speak with you both. Servant says, gentlemen, my master Antonio is at his house and wants to speak to both of you. Serino says, we have been up and down to seek him. We have been looking for him everywhere. We also want to meet him. Serino says, here comes another of the tribe, a third cannot be matched unless the devil himself turns you. Serino says, here comes another man from the same race he is also a Jew. We could not find a third to match these two unless the devil himself were to become a Jew. It will be good for us to go from here. Celino, Celino and servants, go out. Now enter Tubal. Shylock says, how now, Tubal, what news from Geneva? Hast thou found my daughter? He asks. He is worried about his daughter. He asks Tubal, what news from Geneva? Have you found my daughter? Tubal says, I often came where I did hear of her, but cannot find her. I went to the places where I heard some news about her, but I could not find her. Shylock says, why, there, a diamond gone cost me 2,000 ducats in Frankfurt. The curse never fell upon our nation till now. I never felt it till now. 2,000 ducats in that and other precious jewels. I would my daughter were dead at my foot, and the jewels in her ear. Would she were hurled at my foot, and the ducats in her coffin. So no news of them. Why so? And I know not what is spent in the search. Why thou loss upon loss? The thief gone with so much, and so much to find the thief, and no satisfaction, no revenge, nor no look ill luck stirring with what lights on my shoulders, no sighs but of my breathing, no tears but of my shedding. Shylock says, alas, alas, I lost a diamond that cost me 2,000 ducats in Frankfurt. The value of the diamond is 2,000 ducats. The ancient curse never fell upon our race till now. I never felt its effect. 2,000 ducats lost in a diamond alone. And besides, in addition to, I lost many other precious jewels. I wish that my daughter were dead before me with the diamonds in her ear. I wish that dead body was kept at my feet with my ducats in her coffin. Have you no news of them? He asked Tubal, have you no news of them? So much is spent in search of her. I have spent so much money on searching for her. Oh, what loss upon loss. The thief has run. The thief means the daughter of Shylock, Jessica. The thief has run away with so much, and now so much has been spent in trying to locate the thief. Where is she? I have neither satisfaction nor revenge. I cannot revenge from her. Only bad luck has fallen on me. There is no sympathy for me anywhere. No one here to sympathize me. There is no sigh except the sigh that I breathe. There are no tears except the ones shed by me. No one is here to shed tears on my condition. Only myself. Tubal says, yes. Another man have ill luck too, and Antonio, as I heard in Geneva. You are not only one who are unlucky. The other man too have bad luck, Antonio, as I heard in Geneva. Shylock, what? Now he is happy. He says, ill luck, what ill luck? Tubal says, he has hath an Argozy cast away coming from Tripoli. He has had one of his ships wrecked, destroyed while sailing from Tripoli. One of his ship destroyed, wrecked while it was coming from Tripoli. Shylock says, I thank God. Is it true? Tubal says, I spoke with some of the sailors that escaped the wreck. This is the apparently confirmed news, because I spoke to some sailors who were saved from the wreck. Shylock says, I thank thee, good Tubal, good news. Ha ha, where? In Geneva. Thank you, good Tubal, that is good news. Ha ha, where did you hear about them? In Geneva. Tubal says, your daughter is spent in Geneva, as I heard, one night 4 score ducats. Tubal says, yes, I heard that your daughter is spent 80 ducats in one night in Geneva. Shylock says, thou thickest dagger in me. I shall never see my gold again. 40 ducats at a sitting. 40 ducats. Shylock says, I don't want to live now. You stab me with a dagger. I will never see my money again. Because it has already spent 80 ducats and one time, 80 ducats. What happens after that, you will study in my next video. Thank you so much, children. Thank you so much.